Hey, everyone, welcome back to Earthbound. Thank you so much for joining me today. Our main objective for today's video is going to be exploring around One Hut, you know, getting to know the townsfolk and all that. Maybe do some wandering, maybe get some new gear, who knows. Our main goal, at least for now in the game, is that we need to get to Giant Step. You know, it should be located somewhere around here. Smoke that snake, no problem. Don't misread that, I don't smoke snakes often. Hey, we can check out a library and get a lot of interesting information in this area, as this young lady will tell us a lot of info about Earthbound. Basically, it's going to function as our big tutorial area, and I'm really not going to show off much of this, because I will explain most things as we come to them. But I do want to talk to this pretty young lady, so we can borrow a map. Actually, never mind, I changed my mind. Isn't popular with the girls? Oh, well, shit, yeah, absolutely give me one, are you kidding me? Yeah, so you can get all the info, except for the info that isn't there. And, yeah, to access the map, we need to press the X button, which is located near the top of the controller. This lady's so funny! Alrighty, great. So now we hit the X button. Whoa. This place is actually pretty big. Cool, I'm looking forward to showing this off to you guys. Downside to the map is that it does take up an inventory spot, but you can drop it off with Tracy whenever you feel like you don't need it anymore. Use wherever you want. Alright, cool. Of course, there are some areas that aren't marked on the map, but most of the big towns are, so it's pretty sweet. Let's see if her theory worked here. What a cute yellow backpack. Yeah, this lady's noticing me now. Thank you, map lady. Alright, so for the first part, we're actually going to head up in this general direction and talk to one of our old friends, I guess. Can I take over? I'm kind of on like a big adventure right now, buddy. I'm sorry. Yeah. But he's guarding a hideout, and we can actually walk through the trees. Access a little bit of a secret area. Got a cool little kid with a baseball cap. Who's gonna give us a Mr. Baseball cap? Oh yeah, man, this cap is so cool. I've really been wanting this. Thank you so much. The Mr. Baseball cap. And as you'll see here, when I go into my equipment screen, go to other, and we can equip this thing. Gives us a huge defense boost, you know, for a totally free item. It is in a little bit of a hidden area. If you know where this is, that'll give you a big advantage, so definitely come pick that up. Traveling with a cute girl. Alright, yeah, I'll let her know. You're single. Okay, easy, buddy. Easy. Beginning to look like a man. You're so cool. I think... Alright, well, you know, I'm not against, you know, gay people, but I don't swing that way, so, you know, I'm just gonna go ahead and head on out. It's getting a little awkward in here. Getting a little hot. Hey, check this mole out. Not your enemy. It's simply just an average mole, I guess? I don't know. We can get a little bit of a tutorial from these guys. He'll give us some really cool tips. Yeah, basically what I explained in the last video with surprise attacks and all that. You gotta watch the swirls. You wanna make sure you hit an enemy from behind. Don't get hit from behind or side. Blah, blah, blah. And I don't know if you saw earlier. Oh, come on. You're talking so much. Before I talked to this guy, a little butterfly was flying around. If you manage to touch the butterfly as I did there, it will refresh you. It will make you relax, which restores 20 psychic points to your entire team. I don't think I really needed any there. Yeah, because I just rested, obviously. But, you know, it's something to make that... Oh, hey, shit! Yeah, giant step. Do not enter. Alright, well, I need to get there, so... Let's go ahead and head on up. Boom. Take that snake out nice and easy. Looks like there's some clown characters, though. It's kind of freaky. Traveling Entertainer's Shack. Oh, I guess so they live here. That's pretty cool. Do not enter. I don't know about that. There's a big footprint on the hilltop behind the shack. Okay, cool. And it's locked. Oh, shit. The shack has been locked. Oh, that's kind of lame. Some punk named Frank trashed the place. Damn it. So I can't get in here, huh? Well, he mentioned that someone at City Hall closed this place off, so I guess we'll have to wander into town and maybe go to City Hall, see if we can't talk to the mayor or something? I don't know. Alrighty, down we go. Oh, wow, this is really neat. As you can see, definitely a modern RPG. We have, like, paved roads, there was a car that drove by, man, billboards everywhere. The kids have won at B.H. Perkle. Alright, what do you have to say, buddy? Are you okay? Yeah, man, I'm fine. Thanks for calling me helpless, though, or at least helpless-looking. You can go into the most of the houses and talk to the people here. Would you like to have a hint when you're in trouble? Fuck no, absolutely not. You're on your own, good luck. Actually, he's gonna say, if you need a hint, you can find a guy strewn about different area, not strewn about, but he's just hidden in different areas. You can pay him a small amount of money, and he will actually give you some tips as to what you need to do next. Fortunately, these tips cost 35 bucks, and also I know exactly what to do. A young man, yeah, I am very unusual. Thank you. Yeah, he just kind of chills out here for like all time. But, you know, in case we ever need him, I guess it'll be nice. Who knows? So, we're just going to get to wandering. Actually, if we head left, there's some more buildings to explore over here. So, yeah. One of the funny things about Ness is you can make him dig through the trash to find various items. You can even find consumable items like hamburgers that you can eat for, actually, quite a bit. Oh, wait, a truck. Quite a large amount of hit points, but just the fact that you find it in the trash is pretty damn amusing. What is this baseball cap? It is said to have been given to your friend by a famous player at the ballpark. Cool. And a hamburger restores 40? No, 50. 50 hit points, and it's 100% beef, so that's pretty sweet. The arcade. Oh. Sounds like the gang of sharks is hanging out at the arcade. That's pretty interesting. Whoa. Alright, let's make sure we don't get hit by a truck. Actually, getting hit by a truck actually really doesn't do any damage or anything. It just stops right in front of you. Unfortunately, if I sit here and wander around the town and talk to, like, literally everyone, this video is going to... What? An 8 bucks worth of french fries? It'd be better if we eat more expensive foods. Okay, yeah, thanks. If I wander around the entire area and talk to every NPC, this video is going to be about, like, 40 minutes of me just talking to people, and it's going to be pretty darn boring. So, we're just going to cut to the chase here. We're going to get our objectives. Like, right now, I know that I need to go to City Hall. And we're going to talk to people on the way, but if you want to explore around and get a lot more of the humor of the game, I highly recommend you wander around and interact with the citizens, because it is just about hilarious. So, when you're browsing inventory, like, you know, shops and stuff like that, of course you can see how much a shop costs. And also, if your character's little bar there at the bottom, I don't know why I'm pointing at my monitor, starts flashing, that means that the equipment is actually, you know, an upgrade for you, so you're definitely going to want to invest in that most of the time. Like, for instance, a yo-yo is a nice alternative attack weapon for Ness. You know, it's cheaper than the t-ball bat, but it actually has a lot less accuracy, so I pretty much stick with bats for the entire game. Alright, and we don't need a baseball cap because we got that nice free one from our friend, but we could use a cheap bracelet and a t-ball bat. Alrighty, well, let's go ahead and see if we have... I hurt your feelings because I didn't buy anything? Fuck off. So we're going to see if we have enough money to buy both of those things. We have 100 bucks. Unfortunately, that is not going to be enough. So for now, well, hell, I'm just going to get like 50 bucks out. By 50, I mean 40, I guess. We're going to earn some more money very shortly. And we'll come back and buy the cheap bracelet when we do that. For now, though, want that t-ball bat. Hell yes. I would like to equip it here, absolutely. 14 to 18, and it'll give you the option to immediately sell back the weapon that you have equipped, which is pretty sweet. You don't have to worry about interfacing with that. And no, I'm good. Thanks a bunch. Yeah, you're welcome. We talked to this lady here, or is that an old man? Whatever. We can talk to this person on the left and buy a cold remedy in case we catch a cold. Cold basically, well, I don't want to say that. No, I guess so. Cold basically functions like poison in other RPGs. You can actually get poison in this game, but just for a good example, like, you take damage over time, and while you're walking, you actually take damage as well. Until you cure, you're cold. You're being possessed by the game designer? That's crazy. Alright, he's basically explaining what that flashing was. Yeah. Equal to or less than your currently equipped item. If it looks normal, you... if it's like grayed out, the box is grayed out, that means it's just an item that your character cannot equip at all. So of course you don't really want to buy one of those, unless you're holding on to it for a friend, I guess. Alrighty, what else do we have around here? Looks like we found the town hall already, so we can head in there and see what's going on. What do you have on this side? Have any salt your kind-hearted mare? Oh, that's really nice. Yeah, I have a trouble, actually. I need to go to the giant steps, so it sounds like he's going to help us out. We should go to the hospital. If someone dies on your team and you don't have any way of restoring their health, you can go to a hospital and basically they'll just be revived there. Sweet. Shark's boss is hanging out near the giant step. Oh, I thought he was at, like, the arcade. Well, that's interesting. Well, no, wait. The sharks were actually messing up the entertainer's shack, weren't they? Yeah. So there's a lot of snakes and stray dogs around one end, and he's just letting them do whatever they want? You're protesting. Come on. Well, whatever. Let's get exploring around in this area. Doesn't look like this is the mayor. You're in a really foul mood because the mayor doesn't like you? Okay. Oh man, yeah, just running up the clock. Good for you, buddy. Good for you. Aren't you Ness? I don't want to talk about school. My teeth. Well, thank you. What? Don't talk about my bedwetting problems. Get out of here. Why is everyone in town talking about this? It's kind of freaking me out. But as you can see, like, you can find funny things like this. Yeah, why don't you have part-time employees? That's what I want to know. Some suspicious-looking kids are hanging out in the woods north of the library. There's a lot of, like I mentioned, stop talking, woman. Bad influence of the fresh breeze movement. Interesting. As you can see, there's a lot of really useless dialogue in the game, but it adds to a lot of the entertainment value. So you can kind of be missing some of this during the Let's Play. And that's why I encourage all of my viewers, to play the games that I play. I'd love to have you play along. Or, you know, just maybe play it one day if you can just get interested. Because these are truly testaments to great gaming. Anyways, whoop. Hey, I just want to talk to the mayor, actually, so if you don't mind. He's dealing with the sharks and the meteorite. Whoa. Reform the sharks? I didn't say that. I just... What? Scram! Oh, shit. So because he's so busy with the sharks and the meteorite, he won't even talk to us. That kind of sucks. Alright, what's going on? Look, I told you so. Screw you, lady! Well, I mean, she did tell me. So she was just doing her job, so... I guess I should be a little bit more nice. Anyways, the mayor won't even see us. I'm not entirely sure how we're going to get into the entertainer's shack. Very interesting. I guess we can wander around a little bit more. Maybe something will just kind of jump out at us, like this dog. Hey, buddy. Bow wow. Don't you think you'd be needing a weapon? Did you know drugstores sell bats and shit that you can wield to beat the hell out of people? And if you don't feel like walking all the way home, you can stop off at a hotel and stay... Well, oh, man. $35 a night. That is pretty ridiculous, I gotta say. Hey, anything in this trash can? Just plain old garbage. Alright, fair enough, game. Fair enough. Break the course of violence. Don't break the wind of change. Oh, man. Fart jokes. Gotta love fart jokes. Hey, is anyone in here? A Beatles song. Something today. Can I fill in the blanks? Yes. That Beatles song, right? Yesterday. I'm impressed. Yeah, that's the joke. If you answer no, he's like, oh, Beatles song, and you're like, Notre Dame? And he's like, Notre Dame's not a song. Yeah. Oh, Jesus, I got hit by a cab. Okay. So, let's just head a little bit further south. Tons of buildings to explore. Hey, there's a police station. They're probably, like, really busy with the sharks and all that, so I don't think I'm necessarily going to bother them. And a bakery is basically like a burger store. You can buy some more curative items in here. What am I doing on curative items anyway? Not too hot, I'm not gonna lie. We do have a few cure spells though. So that'll be pretty nice. Oh Jesus, this guy... Two guys are running right at us? Oh my god, skate punks. And Yes Man Jr. What the hell is going on here? Ow! Fiercely on a skateboard, 11 damage. Alright, so now I'm gonna talk to you guys about one of the really cool mechanics in this game. Pogo Punk? No, Pogo Punks aren't the cool mechanic. Shit. Okay. So, this game, I don't know if you noticed, but when I get hit and take a lot of damage, my HP ticks down. It doesn't immediately lower to the numerical value. And you can use that to your advantage. If you take critical damage, you can actually cure yourself before your HP rolls down to zero. And if you can get that cure off before it hits zero, you're actually going to survive. It's basically like you have a last chance kind of thing. And also, one thing I failed to mention earlier was that our guts stat, basically the higher that is, it also gives us a chance to, when we take critical mortal damage, we can actually, survive with one hit point, like I do now, and I'm going to try and get a life up off, sweet. If our HPs are maxed out, like it said there, that just means we got full HP from whatever we just ate or casted on ourselves. So yeah, that's a really cool mechanic there. Basically, you get fucked up, you may have a chance to survive. Especially towards later in the game when you have hundreds of hit points. Wow, 40 experience? That's crazy. When you have so many hit points, you're actually going to have a lot longer to cure yourself when you start falling. I would love to meet your boss, yeah. He's in the backyard of the arcade thinking about peace and love? Oh, I guess that's him right there then. Hey Frank, how's it going? Man, I'm too short to kind of poke my head over the fence, so that sucks. And there's the arcade. We could head in there, but I'm afraid we would get our asses kicked, so... I don't want Whoa, let's calm down here. Yeah, at this point in the game, I need to do a little bit of grinding, because unfortunately, playing solo with Ness, you know, even though he's a beast, even at this point of the game, I need to take it easy, make sure I get over-leveled here, so I can handle this situation. Maybe not over-leveled, but we definitely want to gain a few levels. And I want to make sure I stay topped off on HP. Let's go ahead and eat that bread roll. Hey, HP maxed out, sweet. You starting a fight over here? No. Just relax, buddy. And we already encountered the three different types of sharks. Skateboarding, the hula hoop guy, the Yes Man Jr., and the pogo punk. They all have, basically, two different attacks that you need to worry about. They have one special attack where they, like, shred fiercely, or swing their hula hoop, or charge into you. And then they also have an attack where it just does regular attack. Oh, that's a critical hit! But I think I survived it. Sweet. I did survive it, obviously. I'm still here. Woo, that was close. And no, that wasn't a critical hit, sorry, but that was a huge hit that almost killed me, is what I meant to say. The enemies can smash you too, so gotta be a little bit careful. However, I don't think the sharks actually can. Hey, level 5. Maximum HP by 13. Huge upgrade there. That's pretty sweet. And of course, we're gonna loot this sweet, sweet trash can. What do we got going on here? Fruit juice. That's kinda lame. Fruit juice. Let's see here. If you drink this, you recover about 6 hit points. I guess that's kinda nice. Let's go ahead and drink it up. 6 hit points. Sweet. And we're gonna eat this cookie as well. Probably should be using psi points a little bit more, but... Well, I don't know. It's a long walk back to my house, and I'm a cheap bastard. I don't want to have to go all the way there, so I'd have to stay at the hotel. The hotel is $35. Ugh. Unfortunately, the pizza store isn't open either. Alright, we're doing well for health. Let's go ahead and see if we can't take down two of these mothers at the same time. Oh my god. Oh god! Run away! Run away! Run away! Jesus Christ. Okay, sorry about the sudden cut there. Was gonna edit it out towards the end of the fight, but unfortunately, he summoned, you know, a fuck ton of allies to help him out. Those sharks are so annoying! But they're actually the best guys to grind off of at this point. They really do give you a ton of XP, and they also give you a decent amount of money, too. Which I do need to keep in mind, because we still need to buy that cheap bracelet from the drugstore. I like having that thing around. It gives us a little bit more defense. Oh god. Alright, let's lure this guy out so we can only fight one at a time. Oh, and another interesting mechanic. When I start getting in a fight like so, I kind of did it earlier. When that swirl is happening, enemies still will run at us. We're locked in place, and the enemy we touched is locked in place. But it gives the other enemies an opportunity to join in on our fight. So, yeah, you gotta be careful. What I did there, I ran away from the other group of enemies so they couldn't run into this fight and mess me up, obviously. So, yeah, be careful about that. If you have a big group of enemies around you, you wanna be careful how you engage people, because you can get overwhelmed very easily. However, there are certain, like, types of battles, not types of battles, but certain enemy groups, so you gotta be aware of who's around you, because certain groups can't interact with another. Like, I'll be able to explain it a lot more later, but like, not all enemies can help out other enemies in fights. Yeah, and I'll show that off. Whoa, dodge that loop. Okay. Oh god. Doing some really hot dodging here. I gotta say, my luck is on today, which is pretty freaking sweet. Another 25 XPs. And at this point, I'm just gonna walk all the way. Well, actually, we'll walk to the drugstore first and see if we can't buy that bracelet and get our defense up. We should be able to. I think it was like, what, $98? Yeah, that sounds about right. Alright, let's see what we got in the old ATM here. I don't want to use this phone. This is one of the payphones. It's what it costs a buck to use. It kind of sucks. Alright, 200. Wow, yeah, like I said, you get a lot of money, guys. You get a lot of money. And I like to have just a small amount of change on me, so we'll just grab 100. Never know, you might need a little bit of extra cash. When you die in the game and you kind of wipe and you have to continue, you actually spawn at your last save point with half of the money that you had on hand. So yeah, you don't lose any of your progress, like, experience-wise, but you will lose half your cash. So you don't always want to be carrying around a tremendous amount of money on your person, but there are certain areas in the game where you'll be, like, wandering around from, like, a dungeon to the next dungeon or something like that. And there'll be a shop on the way, but no ATM, so you gotta be prepared. Because, yeah, you're not gonna be able to get money as easily as you would in traditional RPGs. Because, you know, obviously monsters aren't dropping all the loot that you need. Sorry if I'm kind of rambling here. Alright, 4 experience. I don't know why I'm not, like, instant killing those dogs. It kind of sucks. We did buy that cheap bracelet. Let's see what we got going on here. Increases defense. Yeah, pretty lackluster description there. But, you know, what can you do? Alright, let's head up into the house and talk to our mom. Oh man, she's gonna cook us some people. Thank God, I've been so hungry. Please, mother, please. Ah, so refreshing. I love that moment, that little fanfare when you take a nap. Pretty much everything about this game. I don't really have any complaints whatsoever. Anyways, mom will say the same old jive for us. And we can call our dad and save our game. I'm feeling kind of sassy, though. So we're not going to save or anything. We're just going to move on. And dodge this dog. Haha. You are too slow, as Sonic would say. You're too slow. Yeah, really annoying. So let's head back down and fight off some sharks. Beat off some sharks, I should say. Aw, oh, dog, what are you doing? You're howling at me. You're pointless. Why am I having to fight you? I don't know. Maybe he's got a little bit more bark than his bite? I don't know. I don't know where I was going with that. Alright, so let's head back down. All the way south. And whoa, check this lady out. What do you have to say? This town's out of control. Wild boys are hanging out in town. The cops have been really cracking down. Tucson, a town in the south. Well, that's interesting. Lynette in Tucson, huh? Well, whatever. Not really seeing a pattern there at all. Alright, with our added defense. Ooh, three sharks, though. We want to be careful. I'll show you what I mean with, like, enemies running in to help them out. Whoa! Well, you kind of saw it. Apparently there was one hiding behind that pizza truck there. Okay. Ah, fuck. 3 of them again? Oh, but he's only doing one Oh, man! Smashed in the face! He's only doing one damage with his basic attack. When they do a charge or special, they will do probably, like, I'd probably say about, like, 6 or 7 hit points. That was a 9. Okay, that's pretty close to what I guess. Now, I'm becoming quite powerful. Yeah. Grinding on these guys. When I'm playing off-camera, I usually grind up to when I get my first powerful psychic move. Wow! Super lucky. However, I'm not going to do that in this game. I'm going to try and keep this somewhat interesting for you guys. I just like getting over-leveled and dominating everything, but obviously, that could be kind of boring to watch. Alright, 53, and now we're level 6. Sweet. Man, it's kind of a shitty level. I think we're going to go ahead and risk it and see if we can't, you know, explore around the arcade. What's going on in here? I think I'm usually like level 8 when I do this, something like that. I'm going to go ahead and pound this hamburger. Let's hold off just a minute here. I beat up your buddy? No, man, that wasn't me. Come on. Okay, yeah, it was me. And I'm going to take this fucking bat upside your face. Come on. Bam. Get out of here. At level 8, you basically kill guys in like one hit. It's pretty ridiculous. And hey, they drop a hamburger, which, yeah, huge healing item for me right now. I love it. What do you have to say, man? A real whiner? Don't get lippy or you kick my butt. You don't say. I would absolutely love to see you try. Hey, what's going on with you, man? You like drinking tea and eating vegetables, but it doesn't fit your cool image? I guess. I don't know. You look like you don't fit in, man. Frank has a really powerful weapon. If we get it, maybe we can stand against any enemy? Oh man, maybe we can, like, take down Gigas with, like, whatever super weapon he has. And I hope you're ignoring the text box up there, because it's pretty damn gross. It's a poem, like saliva spit spit, get some gum, or get your own gum twit. Alright, thanks for that hint, man, I appreciate it. You do have total confidence in your abilities. Are you ready to get it on, Spanky? Oh man, Spanky, that's a beautiful nickname. Ah, he's calling for help, though. I mean, what a pussy. He's all talking all this huge mess to me. Man, I'm so confident in my abilities, and then as soon as we get in a fight, he's like, oh, help! Pogo, man, I need help! Oh, get out of here, Pogo dude, with your short shorts. Oh, fuck, I'm gonna die. God damn, I need to shut my mouth. Lucky for me that I'm not missing too much. I usually have a lot less luck at the beginning of the game. That's kind of why I overlevel. Alright, so let's go ahead and eat this hamburger. Not gonna max this out, but it's still gonna give us quite a bit. Do I want to become a member? Yeah, I guess. Come back after you finish Earthbound. Oh man. It's gonna be forever from now. Well, whatever. For now, I'm just gonna tell him no. Don't be such a snob. Oh, and I said yes, you denied me, dude. What the hell? You're sending me mixed signals here. Yeah, he's laughing hysterically. He's laughing hysterically twice as I'm just beating the shit out of him with a bat. That's actually a pretty horrifying mental image, I'm not gonna lie about it. Alrighty, how we doing on health? Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and top myself up. Fuck it. I'm gonna eat another hamburger, and we're gonna head on out to the backyard, where we're gonna encounter Frank. Check that guy out. Check that haircut out. It's pretty intense. Hold on, I'm gonna see if I can't look at what this thing is. Good lord. Quite a piece of work. Yeah, I have no idea what it is. Alright, whatever. Hey, Frank, how's it going, man? You're Frank, yeah. I can't talk. Don't you know that? I'm the protagonist. Oh, boy. Holy shit. Okay, so we have a pretty intense boss fight here. This motherfucker wielding swords, not swords, knives at us. I really don't have any psychic powers to mess him up with. Oh my god, 24 damage. So we're gonna play this very defensively here. He came out swinging 8 hit points. His knife attack did about 25, so I think I'm gonna be okay for one more round. But then again, he does get the first strike, so we're just gonna play it super safe and life up here. And he lowered our guts by saying something nasty at us. That's fucked up, man. Alright. Hopefully a few more rounds. He doesn't have too many hit points, so I think we're gonna be okay. Yeah, there he goes. Actually doesn't have many hit points at all. But he does so much damage with those knives. I mean, who would have thunk it? Getting stabbed with a knife would really hurt. Can't be beaten. Wait, what? Frankenstein Mark II? Oh, Jesus. Okay, so now we have to fight that giant machine that is in his backyard here. Generated a burst of steam. That is a great thing to see whenever it does that. Ah, shit. Whenever it does that, it kind of wastes its turn. So we're going to just be, again, very defensive. Whenever I get below 30, I'm just going to go ahead and hit a heal up. Because of shit like that, 32 damage in one hit. It's insane. Alright, he's gonna attack me next turn, so I'm gonna go ahead and use another life up. I was hoping he would get the first strike because of, yeah, that. But whatever. As long as he keeps bursting. Oh, but I'm missing. Shit. Okay, we need to get another heal off here. Oh, actually, no we don't. We're totally fine. Excellent. We are the victors. Good deal. Hey, Frank. It's your first defeat. Failure, Frank? Oh, come on, man. Don't be so hard on yourself. Yeah, tell me about Giant Step. Quite powerful spot. It's a kind of special power stored there that allows people to perform wondrous feats. There is a giant monster there, I guess? Who is absorbing the power of the spot, so we may need to be a little bit more careful. Behind the touring entertainer shack, and Perkle, the mayor of Wynette, has a key. Maybe he'll talk to us now that we've beat the sharks? I mean, he was kind of stressing out over the entire situation. Yeah, absolutely. So maybe he'll be kind of like grateful to us? I don't know. But for now, let's head back up, and we're actually just going to go ahead and stay at the inn here, the hotel, and save our game. I'm glad I have my map. I actually kind of forgot where I was. That's embarrassing. So yeah, the city hall is like right north of us here. Alright, hotel time. We're going to need a little bit more dosh on our person so we can actually afford this place. Hey buddy, how's it going? It's not cheap, but you have clean sheets and the rooms are secure. Alright, yeah. go ahead and head into the ATM here. And if you ever want to save your game, like, without having to pay a dollar for the payphones because you're a cheap bastard like me, you can actually... Yeah, I'm going to get rid of all my money. I know I don't need to spend any money right now. And we're going to be heading into a hazardous area. But yeah, if you ever need to use a phone and you don't want to pay a dollar, go into a hotel, because all the phones in the hotels are free. You don't have to worry about a payphone like you would in a drugstore. Alright, $35. Go ahead and stay here. So awesome, man. Such a baller. This child just bought a hotel room, hung out at the night, you know, whatever. Here's a free copy of the morning paper, and every time you stay at a hotel, you're going to get a newspaper the next day, kind of telling you about what you've been doing in the game. Complaints about the Sharks gang suddenly melt into thin air. Yeah, I wonder why. I wonder freaking why. You better be careful. Actually, I single-handedly took down the Sharks lady, so appreciate you to watch your mouth. A group of ruffians spit their gum on you as you were passing by? Yeah, it's probably that guy with the, you know, gum poem up on the second floor. Alright, so we're all rested up. I thought that guy was going to say something different to us, but whatever. Did you say anything different? Yeah, I slept great, thank you. So with that, we're actually going to go ahead and, hey, you can call our mom too. We haven't done that. Mom. Hey, yeah, it's me. Sooner than you got, well, I get really homesick, honestly. Actually, I was making a joke there, but that is, you know, an interesting thing in this game. You can actually get homesick. Wait, Tracy started working part-time for Escargo Express. That's great. But yeah, you can get homesick, and the only way to cure it, well, there is another way, but it's kind of hard to do. You use a certain item. But the only way to really cure your homesickness is to call your mom at home. Basically, being homesick, it makes you, like, disabled randomly in battle. It's pretty funny. It'll be like, Ness suddenly got really sad, something like that. Anyways, we're going to see if we can talk to Tracy. She's working for Escargo Express, apparently. Hey, yeah, it's me. It's part-time for Escargo Express. Basically, like, if you remember at the beginning of the game, yeah, I'm not doing that. She stored item for us. Basically, that's a delivery system where she will pick up items and store them or deliver items from storage. However, it does cost a little bit of money. No, pretty interesting. And having done that, we actually unlocked their phone number. Pretty cool. But for now, oh, a lot of explaining there at the end. I apologize. Hey, $400. That's pretty sweet. Okay. Experience in the next level, and we will be leveling up very soon. But for now, we are going to call this episode and get a good night's sleep, viewers. And make sure you turn the power off when you're done instead of hitting reset. As always, thank you so much. Have a good night, guys.